Movement for Nonviolence and launched the Gandhi-King Awards for Nonviolence. By way of history, the first recipient of this award was His Excellency Kofi Annan, the Secretary General of the United Nations. The next year, it was conferred upon His Excellency President Nelson Mandela in Cape Town in South Africa. Last year, we had my beloved Jane's sister, the illustrious Dr. Jane Goodall, who received it at the United Nations in New York. And today, it's Her Holiness, Sri Mata Amritanandamayi Devi. I now invite Dr. Jane Goodall, the recipient of the award in 2001, to present the award to Her Holiness Ammaji.
Well, I feel that it's a great honor to share a platform with a woman who is so remarkable and who is the very embodiment of goodness. She's had a remarkable life. She has defied tradition from the beginning. Born to a poor family with her skin darker than those of her brothers and sisters. She was not treated well by her family. She was treated as a servant. But she began to feel the presence of God within her. And so powerfully did she feel that presence that she wanted to reach out and share her good fortune with those who were less fortunate than she. And again, defying tradition, she began to embrace those who were in need of comfort. When women were not supposed to touch strangers. And she has comforted with her wonderful hugging, which I experienced yesterday, more than 21 million people. Think of it, 21 million people. But more than that, she has established a vast network of charitable organizations ranging from schools and hospitals and orphanages and building homes for the poor, too many to mention here. And finally, again defying tradition, she was the first religious leader to invest women as priests in the traditional temples. And She believes that God does not discriminate between the sexes. And I believe that she stands here in front of us, God's love in a human body.
അഹിംസാസങ്കല്പം ഒരു വശത്ത് മറുവശത്ത് കർത്തവ്യം എടുത്തുനിന്നുള്ള ഭേദബുദ്ധിയില്ലാതെ മനുഷ്യനെ മനുഷ്യനെ കണ്ട് സ്നേഹിച്ചും അംഗീകരിച്ചുകൊണ്ടുള്ള ഒരു ലോകത്തെപ്പറ്റി
Amma bows down to all of you who are truly the embodiments of supreme love and pure consciousness. Mahatma Gandhi's and Reverend Martin Luther King's beautiful dream of a world in which non-violence prevails, a world without prejudice of any kind, has yet to be fulfilled. Dr. King was courageous like a lion, yet in his heart he was as soft as a flower. He risked his life for the sake of love, equality, and the other noble ideals he upheld. He had to struggle with great perseverance against people of his own country. And Mahatma Gandhi didn't just preach. He put his words into action. He dedicated his whole life to peace and non-violence. Even though he was asked to become the Prime Minister or President of India, Gandhi declined because he had no desire whatsoever for fame or power. In fact, the stroke of midnight, when India was declared independent, Gandhi was found consoling the victims of a riot-affected area. It is in the name of these two great personalities that this award has been instituted. This is in recognition of all those people who pray and work for peace all over the world. May all of them gain more strength and inspiration so that they may accomplish even more. Amma is receiving this award on their behalf. Amma too has a dream. It is a vision of a world in which women and men progress together, a world in which all men respect the fact that, like the two wings of a bird, women and men are of equal value. For without the two in perfect balance, humanity cannot progress. It is easy to awaken someone who is asleep. You just shake the person once or twice. But you can shake a person who is pretending to be asleep 100 times and it won't have any effect. The majority of people belong to the latter category. It is high time that we all truly awake up. Unless the baser animal tendencies in people are subdued, our vision for the future of humanity will not come true, and peace will remain only a distant dream. Let us have the courage and perseverance, born out of spiritual practice, to change this world. For this to happen, each one of us needs to discover and bring to light our innate qualities of faith, love, patience, and self-sacrifice for the good of all. This is what Amma calls true motherhood.